66.44 crore of premium. And this is the first ever vertical to cross this 1 lakh crore of first year premium income. Coming to the market share, friends, as you all know, that today we are working in a highly competitive environment. Apart from LIC, there are 23 private players. And if we see, in the current financial year, our market share is on the rise. And as on 31st March, on composite basis, our market share in NOP was, when the last year we ended on 31st March, it was 74.71%. But as on 31st January, our market share in composite NOP is 77.61%. Almost 3% market share we have regained from our competitor friends. And similarly, in first year premium income, number of policies, number of sales. I'm sorry for using the short form. Number of sales in individual policies which we have completed. And then in first year premium income of individual business, our market share on 31st March was 66.24%. And as on 31st January 2020, the market share is 70.01%. So friends, you will see that whether it is composite NOP or it is composite FYPI, on both the counts, we have regained substantial market share. Now, this is the further breakup. Composite, as I told you, we are having individual business, we are having group business. So this is the breakup. Now, in this slide, I am showing you the market share, what was in January 19, and the market share, what is in January 2020. So here also, if we see composite already we have seen, in individual business, our market share in individual NOP, it is 77.61%. Whereas for the same period, last year in January, it was 73.53%. In individual FYPI, our market share as on 31st January is 52.75%, whereas last year it was 52.74%. In individual scheme, in group schemes, it is 80.72%, whereas last year it was 80.16%. And in group first year premium income, it is 81.51%. Last year it was 77.66%. Now, coming to the growth. Whether it is composite NOP or composite first year premium income, whether it is composite policies or first year, or it is individual number of policy or individual first year premium income, or it is group schemes or group first year premium income, on all the six parameters, the growth of LIC is better than the all private insurers put together. If we see, in composite NOP, our growth is 29.38%, whereas the competitors' growth is only 3.71%. And the industry as a whole is 22.5%. It means if we can say LIC is driving the industry because our growth is far, far better than the competitors. Similarly, in composite FYPI, our growth is 42.85%, whereas the competitors' growth is only 20%. The further breakup also I have shown in the slide, which is visible to you. On all six parameters, our growth is better than the competitors. Now, coming to the product basket. Friends, for catering to the different types of needs of our honorable prospects and customers, we are having very rich product basket, variety of products we are having, whether it is whole life, or it is endowment, or term insurance product, or the products for the children, pension or annuity products, micro insurance products catering to the needs of low income group, similarly health insurance product, ULIP, special products for HNI segment, online products, and apart from that, we are running some government schemes also. Friends, as on date, we are having four online products. LIC's Tech Term, it is available online. LIC's Cancer Cover, it is also available online. LIC's Jeevan Shanti, available online as well as offline both. Then Pradhan Mantri Vay Vandan Yojana, that is also available online as well as offline. As far as this online business vertical is concerned, this LIC Tech Term was launched on 1st September 2019. And for the convenience of our online customer, we have introduced this video MER facility for their convenience. Similarly, one call center is being arranged to assist and guide our online customers for completing the process easily. And in the current financial year, up to 31st of January, we have completed 15,780 policies online, under which we have procured 520.66 crores of premium. Now, when we have launched this LIC Tectum, this is term insurance product, and this benefit of improved mortality, we have passed on to the customers, and we have reduced our this term insurance premium substantially. Now our tech term product premium is highly competitive in the market. And if you see in this slide, a 30-year-old male individual non-smoker, suppose he goes for 2 crores of insurance under tech term, for 10-year term, the premium, annual premium comes to 16,360, which is almost 45 rupees per day. Very affordable, on affordable price we are offering it. Similarly, for even for female lives, it is further lower. A female life, 30-year age, non-smoker, for 10-year term, the premium comes only 15,720 annual, which is almost 43 rupees per day. Now, we are having health insurance products also. Two products we are having as on date. One is Jeevan Aarogya, another is Cancer Cover. And till 31st of January, we have completed 2,42,328 policies, health policies, under which we have procured 78.17 crore of premium. Out of this 2,42,000 policies, 1,47,000 are under Cancer Cover. And in this year, we have paid 11,776 health insurance claim, under which 39.89 crore of claim amount has been paid. Now, adding to the human resources, this year in 1920, we have added the human resources in a big way. You can see in the slide that in the current financial year, we have recruited 433 class 1 officer, we call them assistant administrative officer. They are already undergoing training in Mysore. We have also recruited 4,414 apprentice development officers. This is our part of the field force. They manage the team of agents. So 4,414 new apprentice development officers have been recruited, and they are already in the branches now. Apart from that, we are also going to recruit 8,000 assistants. Soon they will be joining within a couple of weeks. And in the current financial year, we have recruited 1,33,706 agents. And in those 1,33,000 agents, almost 30,000 are career agents. Career agent is a scheme where we, apart from commission, we pay some stipend also to the agent to make him full-timer. Okay. Now, coming to the customer service, it has been our endeavor always to at least come up to the expectation of our customer. This dedicated online, this call center is already operational. SMS helpline is operational. We are having across the country 73 customer zones, and we are having this integrated complaint management system also. Now, coming to the e-services, those policyholders who have registered on our portal, they can get all these online services, e-services, through the portal. Now, coming to the fulfilling our promise, claim payments. Friends, in the current financial year, we have settled 5,99,881 death claim in 10 months' time, under which we have paid 9,866 crore of claim amount. And we have also settled 1,42,93,289 maturity claims, under which 69,748 crore of premium amount has been paid. And our 96.8% of non-early death claims are settled within 15 days of the intimation. New initiatives, lot of new IT initiatives have been taken, and all those things are listed in this slide. and we are in the process of upgrading our hardware and software both. Coming to the digital initiatives, friends, last month our chairman sir has inaugurated this AI voice enabled chatbot, which is available on our website. Name is Jeevan Mitra, and in 1 month's time, 1,13,483 users have made use of it, and there were 4,71,891 queries. Apart from that, we have made available this customer portal services to our customers available. Already 1,30,78,231 users have registered, and the total policies registered in the portal are 2,92,22,933. Friends, coming to the investment, at the end of 6 months of the current financial year, as on 30th September 2019, in current financial year, 6 months' time, our gross investments were 2,49,018 crore. For the same period last year, it was 1,52,894 crore. So there is a growth of almost 62.87%. And our investment assets as on 30th September 2019 are 31,06,473 crore, and year-to-year growth comes to almost 8.04%. In investment, we make our investment in three major instruments, that's government security, equities, and debt. Up to 31st of January, in current financial year, in government securities, we have invested 2,81,134 crore. In debts, we have invested 58,615 crore, and in the equities, we have invested 46,850 crore. We also realize profit by selling the equities from time to time, and in the current financial year, up to 31st of January, we have realized a profit of 23,273 crore. Friends, we have the presence in other countries also, and presently we are present in 14 countries, which are shown in the slide. In some places we are having branches, three places, UK, Fiji, and Mauritius. In Singapore we are having fully owned subsidiary, and in other countries our presence is through joint venture. Every year we have to do our valuation and of our assets and liabilities, and whatever surplus is generated, as per the Act, 95% goes to our policyholder in the form of bonus, and the 5% goes to the government as their share in valuation surplus. And last year in 18-19, the valuation surplus was record 53,214.41 crore, in which government share was 2,610.74 crore, and this surplus check was handed over by our chairman sir in the last week of December, which you must have seen in the newspaper also. Friends, thank you very much. Thanks for your attention, and this was a brief presentation from my side. Thank you.
It's okay, Rajivan, we'll manage from here on.
There's the question. Yeah, friends, thank you very much. Thank you, Joshi. Now I'd request our chairman, esteemed chairman, Shemar Kumar sir, to address the gathering.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Thanks to everyone for coming here today. I know that you have a lot of pressure wanting to be somewhere else also today at the same time. So very nice of you to come here. I just want to add something to what Mr. Joshi presented to you. At the beginning of the year, whatever decisions we took in terms of budgets and achievements, we also took a conscious decision to step up the sales of non-single premium policies and number of policies. There are two, three reasons for that. We believe that coverage should be more important than penetration or density of premium. That is basically a European or an American philosophy. In India today, we need to cover more and more people. We still haven't covered more than 30% of the population. So we took a conscious decision to step up sales in this area, and there we have succeeded. One reason why we didn't do it earlier, you might ask, is that there was this overhang fear of losing market share if you do not sell single premium. But I think our field force and people down the line have managed admirably well in order to balance both the single premium and the non-single premium in such a fashion that not only we have grown on all the segments, but we have also been able to maintain or increase the market share, as Mr. Joshi has already shown you. On term cover, I just want to make this comment that there was always a complaint that LIC premium rates were very high. So again, we did a lot of work on that. We brought down the rates substantially. And I'm not saying this as a kind of a thing that is likely to happen, but the way things are shaping up and the kind of stress that is there in reinsurance business today for term, it is likely that term cover rates may go up in the near future. And this is what we are foreseeing. But we hope to maintain the rates that we have on our term cover as of now. Other than that, the big thing that happened this year was that our pension and groups vertical has for the first time crossed 1 lakh crore business, the first time ever it has happened in the history of the corporation. And that again has bolstered the market share to a great extent. On claim payments, some coverage was done by Mr. Joshi. That you know that LIC has always been very devoted, I would say, to claim settlement operations, both maturity and death claims. A couple of years back, we had this small shift to digital payments, and we tried our best to switch over to digital in a big way. But we found that some of the old policies that were coming up for maturity, 25, 30-year-old policies, we were finding it difficult to get the NEFT particular. It still is the case today. But then we have steadily reduced over the years the payment by check. And this year, again, a very conscious effort has been taken by us that we shall not make any check payment at all. And we must have seen that we have come out a lot of ads, requesting policyholders to get us our NEFT details, your bank details, so that direct payment, digital payment is enabled. Basically, this in short is what I wanted to add. But I know all of you are looking forward to asking a lot of questions on many other things that I may or may not be able to speak about, but then the house is open and I leave it to you.
Sir, this is Yash here from CNBC TV.
Yes, Yash.
Of course, as you rightly mentioned, some things which you did not mention and are in the news. The first question itself, just in the month of October, quoting you, you said that it's too early for LIC to come out with an IPO and go public. I mean, in Feb, there's an announcement on the IPO. What has really changed in this time that you're ready to go public?
Let me just put it this way that, yes, I did say that. I admit I said that. But perhaps I've been overruled. What more can I say?
So are you ready to go public then in your understanding now?
Haji.
आपके हेड ऑफिस से लेकर के तमाम सारे देश के अलग अलग ब्रांचेस में एजिटेशन हो रहे हैं पहला उनको नौकरी जाने का खतरा है दूसरा जो क्लेम सेटलमेंट को लेकर के चीजें हैं जैसे आपने बताया 95% आपने सेटलमेंट किया उनकी चिंता है कि अगर फ्लेक्सिबल होता है शेयर मार्केट नीचे गिरता है तो क्लेम सेटलमेंट में दिक्कत आ सकती है और इसलिए पब्लिक आकर के उनके साथ झगड़ा कर सकती है इस तरीके की चीजें जो आ रही हैं इस पर क्या है
नहीं मैं ये कहना चाहूंगा कि कहीं ना कहीं ये बात हो रही है कि प्राइवेटाइजेशन इसका उत्तर शायद सेक्रेटरी इकोनॉमिक अफेयर्स ने कल दिया है पेपर में भी आया है कि दिस इज नथिंग टू डू विद प्राइवेटाइजेशन गवर्नमेंट इज ओनली पॉसिबली डाइवेस्टिंग अ पार्ट ऑफ इट एंड देयर आर मोस्ट ऑफ द पब्लिक सेक्टर बैंक्स टुडे आर लिस्टेड न्यू इंडिया एश्योरेंस इज लिस्टेड GIC री इज लिस्टेड ऑल दिस लिस्ट ऑफ दे कंटिन्यू टू बी गवर्नमेंट कंपनीज सो एब्सोल्युटली देयर इज नो प्रॉब्लम फॉर द स्टाफ और द एम्प्लॉयज दे विल कंटिन्यू टू बी LIC एम्प्लॉयज विच इज गोइंग टू बी more or less wholly controlled by government. So I don't see any reason why, I mean, there is a reaction. No doubt there is a reaction, but then I think we will be talking to them and making them understand. Ek baat ye. Dusri, aapne claims ke bare mein pucha. There should be no problem for policyholders at all. And Madam FM has gone on record saying that sovereign guarantee will continue. So that being the case, I don't think there is anything to worry about for the customers as
Recruitment
well.
ko lekar ke bhi un logon ne, jaise 14 alag alag jo 20 संगठन हैं आपके यहाँ रजिस्टर्ड उन्होंने रिक्रूटमेंट को लेकर के भी दिक्कत जताई कि जो रिक्रूटमेंट LIC कर रहा है उसमें भी चेंजेस आ जाएंगे क्योंकि पब्लिक एक बार इसमें इंटरेस्ट हो जाएगा शेयर मार्केट में आ जाएगा तो फिर तमाम सारी दिक्कत
नहीं यही मैं कह रहा हूँ ना अगर आप बाकी पब्लिक सेक्टर बैंक्स को देखें या किसी और को देखें कहाँ पे जहाँ पे लिस्टिंग हुई है, क्या आपको लगता है कि ऐसा कुछ हुआ है? आई डोंट थिंक सो. तो आई डोंट सी एनी रीजन व्हाई इट शुड बी डिफरेंट हियर.
पड़ेगा वैल्यूएशन पे, और ये अगर नहीं होता तो और ज्यादा अच्छा रिस्पांस मिलता, ज्यादा बेहतर रहता, क्योंकि दो चीज है, दोनों अपने आप को कॉन्ट्रडिक्ट कर रही है.
सेक्शन 80C बहुत दिनों से है इन सम फॉर्म ऑफ द अदर. पहले आपको याद होगा कि कई साल पहले सिर्फ इंश्योरेंस के लिए देयर वाज अ काइंड ऑफ एन एलिमेंट अवेलेबल, देन ओवर अ पीरियड ऑफ टाइम इट हैज बीन एक्सटेंडेड टू मेनी थिंग्स. तो आज मुझे लगता है कि सिर्फ टैक्स के लिए कोई निवेश कर रहा है LIC में, आई डोंट थिंक इट इज देयर. हम भी इसकी बात करते नहीं है, नंबर वन. नंबर टू, अगर आप अपर सेगमेंट को देखेंगे, द इनकम सेगमेंट को, दे डोंट हैव इशू विद द टैक्स. और जहां LIC काम करती है, बोथ इन द अपर एंड द लोवेस्ट सेगमेंट्स, रूरल मासेस, देर इज नो इश्यू ऑफ टैक्स इशू. सो मुझे नहीं लगता कि 80C से इससे कोई या इंश्योरेंस सेल्स पे कोई इम्पैक्ट होगा.
सर, जिस दिन बजट में जैसे ही वित्त मंत्री ने ऐलान किया था, तो हमने देखा था जो जो अभी लिस्टेड स्टॉक्स है वो 12-13% तक गिर गए थे, और उन्होंने ऑन रिकॉर्ड भी कहा कि ये इंश्योरेंस सेक्टर के लिए सेंटिमेंटल थोड़ा नेगेटिव होगा.
आई डोंट अग्री. जो जिस दिन गिरा उसके बाद दो दिन के बाद उठ भी गया, उठा भी है ना. सो मे बी इट लॉस 900 points, आफ्टर दैट आई थिंक 1300 points सेंसेक्स निफ्टी हैज गेन्ड.
So just to follow up to that question, of course you said because of ATC there won't be a material impact that you see. But on the other front, when it comes to the dividend distribution tax, now it will shift to the receiver, which in this case would be you on behalf of your policyholders. When you pay that dividend, tax on that dividend that you receive, what kind of impact do you see at taking place? Bottom line, sir?
It's too early to answer this question. We'll take it as it comes. I mean, it's too early for me to comment on what, I mean, the kind of dividend that will be payable or that the amount that will be taxed. And how we will look at it, I don't think I can answer today.
Sir, as far as Saraswati here from Money
Ma'am
Control.
Ma'am, 1 second, please.
So,
one request from everybody, please.
Yeah. Yeah, sure.
Sir, Saraswati here from Money Control. Wanted to understand from you, as far as the numbers are concerned, you've a pretty good set of numbers. But if you look at, you know, for the period ended September 2019, the gross NPLs had already crossed 6%. Whereas, you know, if you look at someone like SBI, their NPLs are also close to 6.9%. So what would be some of the steps which LIC is taking to kind of look into the bad debts?
No, actually, if you look at, I mean, the stress, if any, for banks is quite different than the stress that we have in insurance companies. And they are mostly on a lending and they have most of it on corporate debt. For us, most of our investments is comprised of government securities, equity, and a small portion of corporate debt. The 6% you're talking about possibly is part of the corporate debt. But if you look at it overall, it's hardly even 1% gross. And we make provisions for everything. So net is hardly how much? 0.04. So, I mean, there's quite a big difference. It's all question of how you look at it, basically.
Because your 30,000 crore, you know, the NPA exposure is there in some of the entities which are...
But the assets are 32 lakh crores. So, straight away, it's 1% only.
Just one more thing from my side, sir. As far as the product mix is concerned, ULIPs have, you know, traditionally been much lower. So, is there a rejig as far as strategy is concerned? Or
yes,
would you like to?
I agree with you. And in fact, if you look at the non-single premium space, there are two parts to it. One is the non-ULIP and one is the ULIP part. As of now, yeah, we're not very much present in the ULIP portion. But if you look at the non-ULIP portion of the non-single premium, you'll find that 80% of the market share is ours. Yes, we are going to get into the ULIP segment in a very strategic and a very aggressive manner. We are awaiting a product approval from IRDAI. We are expecting it very soon. And personally, I would like to see it launched before the end of this month.
Hello, sir.
There are not much changes. These are all minor changes happening in product regulations. One deals with surrender, where the policyholder can now surrender it, you know, after 1 year, or rather 11 months, 2 years basically. Two, there is a something called a suitability format introduced, into order to create awareness, in order to ensure that the customer is getting the right product. So the intermediary will have to fill up a suitability format where he will explain every product to the customer. He will also keep a record of that. The customer will also, you know, agree or respond saying that, yes, I have understood and I believe that this is the right product for me. So there are basically very small changes, but at the revival. Now, almost all, except for a Jeevan Shanti, our annuity product, which had already undergone change earlier. Bima Bachat. Other than that, all products have undergone.
What is the premium hike in the relaunch product compared to the earlier product?
Do you have that? No, I don't. You have the...
Sir, in FY19...
Premium will not change, no?
There
is no change in the premium. Yeah, sorry.
Mr. Kumar, Manojit from the Hindu. I wanted to know, Mr. Kumar, yeah, Manojit Shah from the Hindu. I wanted to know how will your investment policies will change following this IPO, particularly in the equity segment, and what does the IPO mean for the policyholders?
See, I can't talk about investment because we'll have to wait. We have not done the math, basically. So a lot of figures are being bandied around on market capitalization, on, you know, the kind of the size of the IPO and things like that. But unless we do our internal discussion and the math, I don't think we'll be able to come up with that any kind of answer for that today. But sir, as and when we do some work on that, let me assure you that we will come back to you.
Sir, one question.
It has to be reasonable, valuation has to be reasonable, it has to be done properly, scientifically. There's a lot of work to be done.
So, investment policies, sir,
you do a lot of equity investments. So how that policy will change?
I can't say as of now. Okay. And generally speaking, since the regulation is not changing on the investment, there is investment regulation. So whether we are listed or not, I believe we will have to follow the same investment regulation.
Sir, तमाम सारे ऐसे सेक्टर्स हैं, खासकर महाराष्ट्र में रियल एस्टेट और दूसरे सेक्टर्स जिनके लिए महाराष्ट्र गवर्नमेंट फंड से लिक्विडिटी की तलाश कर रही है, क्या LIC के पास अप्रोच करेगी अगर लोन के लिए या उस सेक्टर को बूस्ट करने के लिए?
ऐसे तो बहुत सारे स्टेट गवर्नमेंट्स अप्रोच करती हैं. सो स्टेट गवर्नमेंट्स आर एलिजिबल टू टेक स्टेट डेवलपमेंट लोन्स व्हिच इज नाउ थ्रू द RBI रूट. इट इज वी कैन बिड, वी हैव टू बिड फॉर इट. सो उसमें तो लोग ले ही रहे. बियॉन्ड दैट देयर इज नथिंग.
Sir, in FY19, the dividend which you paid to the government was 2,611 crore rupees. We are almost in the second month of the last quarter. What could be the dividend amount for...
Oh, Yash, I wish I could tell you that.
Would it be more than...
Once we are listed, we will try to say those things, you know.
And sir,
which will enhance the share, but the now, as of now, it makes no difference really.
Sir, does the government have any plans to increase the equity capital of 100 crore which it has in the company right now before the IPO?
This is something they will have to answer, but as I said, we have to work on it. We are talking to the government. We'll have series of discussions with them. And once we internally decide on something, except price or market sensitive information, anything other than that, I'll be able to come back to you on this.
Hi sir, this is Surbhi from the Hindu Business Line. Sir, two questions. One is that when do you start work on the IPO and by when do you see it happening? Because Delhi, they've said it is likely in the second half of the fiscal. Secondly, does LIC plan to focus more on digital sales given the huge agent network that you have? Thank you.
All right. Okay, on the first question, yes, Secretary of Finance has gone on record saying that second half of 2021. We have to sit down and work it out. I don't know how long it takes for the very simple reason that we are doing it for the first time. So we have not done this before, right? So if there's something that I had done before, I would have given you some timeline, but I can't put a time to it, number one. Number two, on the digital, yes, absolutely, we have to be, we have the online products as Mr. Joshi showed you, but we still believe that feet on the street matter a lot to the Indian public. We are more comfortable, you know, talking to the agent, eyeball to eyeball contact and getting to know the things, especially now with the suitability format introduced by IRDAI. It makes more sense for someone to actually go out and sell the policy rather than, unless people are really comfortable about doing it online. And if you've noticed, and I think this is the case with other insurance companies as well, most of the online sales happens on the term cover. Not on the other, because there are many other questions to be answered on the other products.
Sir, this is Suvashree from Bloomberg News. I wanted to understand two things. One, a continuation of your previous question. What is exactly the corollary, the chronology?
I thought you said coronavirus.
I will come to that. That was my second question. You preempted it. The chronology of this IPO, I mean, if you can just give us some breakup of from internal to external.
I tell you what. I mean,
and second
this
question,
is something you should ask an investment private banker.
Exactly. So you
I mean, whatever is, you know, the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, it is to be done. Whether it is LIC or any other company.
So my question was basically, you know, if you could give us some specifics about, for example, in the next 2 months, you will tie up with XYZ, then we will do the, I mean, is there any...
You said it.
No, I want to know from you, sir. I'm giving you, I mean, I'm trying to understand the specifics over here.
Pardon?
Second.
You will be the best one to understand the financials and the valuations of your company.
Sir, if I can finish my question, sir, I think this is my
Let's finish. Bloomberg. One second. I'll come back to you. Bloomberg.
So I want to understand the specifics of the chronology of your IPO. And second, sir, are you kind of doing anything on the as you said, the coronavirus? Is there anything, any new policy or anything that you're kind of thinking about on that line?
So chronology is, I mean, I don't know it. I have not studied it. We are doing it for the first time. But I'm sure the chronology will be the same as what other IPOs undergo. And probably we'll borrow a lot from some of the PSU non-life insurance companies that have been listed in the recent times. On the coronavirus, no, we don't have any product as such. We don't see that any immediate need for that. I mean, unless it, once it becomes a contagion, I hope not, or a pandemic, then, I mean, even insurance may not help. So,
Sir, Anand from Business Today. Sir, what should be the optimal level of capital for LIC? Because you have 100 crore...
Sorry, where are you? Oh, yes.
So you have 100 crore, you know, paid up capital and, you know, total assets of almost 30 lakh crore. So what should be the optimal level of capital if you can give some,
I can't. I mean, you have not done the math. If you have done the math, you can give us some idea. I will start from there.
So in terms of your valuation, would you be including the value of the land on your books or for the purpose of IPO, of course, or would you be excluding that?
I suppose it should be. I mean, everything will get added. You know, you want to do a good valuation.
Correct. And what's the value of land on the books? What's the value of land on the books?
I don't have the figure. That's what I said. We have a lot of work. See, we are on the land, on real estate. We have been very passive in the sense that we have done the investment only for long term. We have hardly sold any of our real estate, right?
Exactly.
So unless I do the math, unless I do the valuation of that, that also has to be valued now. So I can't give a figure.
So as far as LIC is, you know, IDBI Bank.
Oh yeah. Money control.
Yeah. As far as LIC's IDBI Bank stake is concerned, after the majority acquisition, if you could tell us as to how it is benefited in terms of policy sales as well, and will you also be sprucing up your bank assurance presence?
Yes, bank assurance. In fact, IDBI Bank is the number one bank assurance partner now. They've almost crossed 500 crores of new business premium, and that is what we wanted to do. They were originally targeting 2,000 crores for the year, but then at this stage, I believe they may cross 1,000 crores, which would be the highest ever done by any bank assurance partner for us. And on the acquisition, yes, we have 51% stake. We are waiting for, the government has also announced, I think, in FM's budget that there is some disinvestment going to happen on the IDBI from the government side. Once that happens, I see that some private equity people coming in, private partners coming in. And once that happens, I think people will show more interest in the script, because otherwise, as of now, with 51 with us and 46 with government, there's hardly any float for us to, you know, maneuver there, the share price.
But you also have to, I mean, the special exemption given by IRDA for the LIC stake purchase was that the 15% you have to come.
Correct.
Down. So
correct.
Have you, the timeline?
Timeline has not been fixed by IRDA. However, Reserve Bank has given a 12-year period. We may not want to wait that long, especially if we are also going to be listed. But we'll have to find some way of unlocking the value of IDBI, making them come. Once they come out of PCA and they start lending, I believe that their profitability will go up substantially. In fact, not only doing insurance business for us, even our LIC mutual fund is having a tie-up with them. And there also, they are number one They've done 100 crores of business for LIC mutual fund. So I believe that there are a lot of synergies happening in the IDBI space, and going forward, it is going to work out well for them. We don't have in ITC more than 15%. We don't have anywhere.
Companies in which you have more than 15%, by when do you plan to reduce?
We don't have, except IDBI. In 16. Now it is a little down because there is some rebalancing happening there.
So
I don't
except,
know.
Except
is
IDBI, it, you've complied with every.
It might be. Might be slightly more, but that we will try to bring down.
But except IDBI and let's say ITC, you've complied with all of the.
Yes, yes, absolutely.
Okay. So Brihadish from VC Circle here, in a follow up to the IDBI question, would you be in order to make it, reduce your stake and make it viable for the other private parties to, purchase into the company?
So
will you be looking at, capitalizing it, or will you be looking at, starting the process anytime soon?
Not as of now. Since government itself is going to offload, we will not do any offloading as of now, but we will wait for a better, a price, because our acquisition price is much more than what it is today. So we will wait for that to happen.
Do you have the venue to capitalize it for them to start lending before?
We don't have to do that. No. No more capitalization is required. Of all the parameters, they had only profitability as one parameter as per the RBI guidelines, which they had not achieved. But then I think RBI might possibly waive that, because unless you do this, they can't become profitable. And next quarter, I see them coming to the positive side, green side.
Sir, you have the cancer cover. I mean, the indemnity, why you are not interested in re-indemnity as in some product? When some of the players have already reached the regulator, you are the largest player, so why you are not interested?
So, yes, a couple of players have approached IRDAI for selling indemnity type of products, and there is already, two ways of looking at it. The non-life insurance companies do not like the idea, obviously. But as far as we are concerned, we have been stating this, that we have this, the product that is guaranteed kind of product. But on the life insurance space, there is a lot yet left to be done. As I said, the coverage is still around 30%. We have a lot more things to be done, and we would like to focus on that before getting into indemnity kind of health insurance products.
Sir, do you have any idea when you're going to file the DRHP, and also...
No timelines are known as of now. I wish I could tell you, but I don't have it.
Will there be a pre-placement offer kind of thing before the IPO to private?
Are you interested?
I don't have the money.
Sir, Suvashri, once again. Sir, I just wanted to ask, understand, overall the economy is seeing slowdown, and even LIC's books are seeing a little bit of pressure. Even if the asset base is huge, the absolute number of defaults is seeing a little bit of pressure. So in this context, firstly, are you seeing this pressure continuing over a period of time going ahead, and how you think that could impact the valuation of the huge giant that LIC is in terms of, opening your books to the investment bankers?
So on that, two parts to your question. One is that, whatever stress is there in the market, I think to some extent you are seeing it coming out of that stress. The mechanisms of IBC and CLAT have been working. Recently, SR Steel, 92%, I think the bankers got back. We were not much invested in that. So we see these kind of things happening more often. And I believe that the stress will not go away, but it will reduce substantially. So over a period of time, I do not think that it is going to impact our valuation in any way.
Do you think you'll have to work on that as well in terms of how you use your pool of capital and in terms of government interference?
Yeah, I believe. Perception, as I see it, is very positive as of now. We have 29 crore policyholders. So I believe that, and we have 12 lakh agents. So I can't think of any other organization which has gone for an IPO with this kind of a base. So this is the kind of people who trust us, the 29 crore policyholders, 12 lakh agents working for us. So there the perception is very strong. Any negative perception that is getting built, out of here and there, is something that has to be addressed. So that we will address maybe with the employees, maybe with some other people who might like to believe that the valuation is not as good as it should be, or it could be better kind of thing.
From the investor. From the investor.
Uh-huh. we will have to address that perception, because that bring, see, once you list, you are going to bring around transparency, as FM has rightly said. Corporate governance has to absolutely increase substantially, and I believe we are in a position to do that. Now, even though we are not mandated, we are publishing our quarterly results in the paper. I don't know, some of you would have seen it. We are not mandated to do it, but we are doing it. And we have been doing all those things that are necessary to be done, maybe in a listed kind of environment. We've been doing it for years, for decades. So I don't see any reason why we can't, you know, make that perception go away, if there is a perception like that.
Hello, sir. Hi. This is Rupam here from Reuters. Just two quick questions. You know, your the announcement which came from the ministry was considered also as a moment of a Saudi Aramco moment for India. And secondly, also, you know, of course, you're talking that the math has to be done and there's a lot to be, the homework is yet to begin. But if you could just put together a timeline for us that how you're going to spruce up before an IPO, because the, you know, the volume of the business and also the scale of LIC is something, you know, one would wonder how to go get started with. Thank you.
Okay. So volume of business does not, you know, impact the process that we are looking at. The process, as I said, somebody asked chronological, it has to be the same as anybody else has done. Only the figures are going to be different. So we will have to work on that. We'll have to work on, you know, getting together what all will be part of the valuation, do the valuation part, embedded value, all those things. And then maybe with two or three rounds of discussion, maybe with the government, we come to the next level or next stage in the chronological order. So other than that, as of now, as I said, yeah, you said it, that we have started doing our homework. But it's not that we have to do much. But then, as I said, this is the first time we are doing this. So there are many new things to be done, which we haven't done before, and we will be working on that.
Sir, I'm
many things, anybody who has done an IPO only can say that. So no, priorities will be to enable perception that somebody asked, to create a right perception, right attitude in the market, and work on how to build up the valuation, what is the process of valuation, work on that. And continuously this year, like you've seen the financials, we want to end the year on a high. We want to do, this is the first time in decades probably that we are within, you know, a year short of achieving the budget and all the parameters of number of policies and premium income and settling all the claims. So we are focused. Next 2 months will be more focused on the business closures also. So then simultaneously we will be taking up this work.
Sir, one question on the business and the...
Sorry? 1st February was the announcement. Today is 7th. What do you expect would have happened in 6 days? Come
on. Sir, one question on the business itself. As far as the business figures are concerned, the premium growth, you've been growing very strongly when it comes to the group business. But the growth as far as the APE or the individual business is concerned is not as strong.
It is. I said in the beginning that consciously we shifted from single to non-single to premium.
Correct. But how do you expect the margins to get impacted in that case? Because, of course, the margins are more attractive when it comes to the APE or the retail side of the business.
Retail.
It's 40%.
APE we are ahead, no?
What is your VNB margin at this point of time?
I don't. You have the figure?
VNB margin I don't have, but on non-single premium we have 40%.
40% growth. After many years.
29.
Sir, my name is Rajas. I'm a columnist with New Indian Express Group. My question is basically about, you know, the IPO, which we are all talking about. Are there any regulatory issues that need to be tackled, especially LIC is incorporated under the LIC Act, and then there is IRDA, then there are SEBI regulations. So is there some sort of a amendment required to the LIC Act?
Basic amendment will be required to the LIC Act. It's a legislative work that has been done by the Government of India. Apart from that, regulatory issues, I don't think many, because most of the insurance companies operating are already listed companies under the same regulator. So yes, you're right that legislative changes will have to happen, and I suppose that will take its course.
Okay, so that time also we have to take into account for...
Yes, we have no control over that time.
The other thing is there any, you know, conversation in the past 6 days that has happened, that whether it's an offer for sale by the government or you are
really pushing it. No, 6 days, nothing. But I'll be going and meeting. As I told you, we'll come back to you. I mean, this is not a one-off kind of meeting. We will have meetings in future as well. When again? Yes. Pardon? Whoever has to be met, come on. Pardon? Oh, yes. Madam is in town, I know.
Amount for the current year, I think includes LIC stake sale as well. So does it mean that the company wasn't somewhere involved in helping the government put together those numbers, sir?
No. We were not involved. That is basically a finance ministry's concern of how they work it out. And we were not involved. I was not entirely surprised, let me put it that way. Because I'll tell you why. Because this is something that is being talked about for not the first time. No? It's been talked about 5 years back, 3 years back as well. So all of us, I mean, we know at some point of time it's going to happen. That's true. We will have to talk to them and address their concerns. Is some people going around saying that the word privatization is being used, so people naturally are concerned. So that has to be addressed. There is no question of any privatization here. Most public sector banks and other entities continue to be government-owned entities, even though their shares are listed in the market. So we will address that.
Sir, could you elaborate on...
That's what you want to put, you get put.